As many of you have noticed via Twitter, I've been searching for and evaluating various off-site or remote backup solutions for my business data. I have tens of terabytes of video footage and various assets, and your standard cloud storage services just aren't going to cut it. Since I've been working with Synology for my in-office storage solutions, they wanted me to check out their new C2 Backup service integrated into their NAS operating system and sponsor another tutorial. They even have a 30-day free trial available so you can evaluate it for yourself. Let's give it a look. Thanks to Western Digital for sponsoring this NAS build and my overall storage solutions with their WD Red 6TB network storage drives, which are made to last for a very long time with constant uptime and keep your data safe, and they still deliver it fast over the network from your storage solution. Check WD out via the link in the video description. Synology C2 Backup is a cost-effective integrated cloud backup solution for your Synology NAS. By being integrated into your NAS, it's easy to use, and their data center located in Frankfurt meets the high privacy standards required by EU regulations. You can schedule your backups, maintain versioned file history, and recover it with multiple methods. Let's see how to set it up. You can install Synology C2 through the Hyper Backup package in the Package Manager. Install the Hyper Backup utility and run it. Once it's open, you'll be prompted with the Backup Wizard, also accessible by clicking the plus in the bottom left-hand corner and hitting Data Backup Task in case it doesn't come up for you. Here, you can choose to backup to a variety of cloud services, including manual rsync settings. Here, we will select Synology C2 Cloud Backup and hit Next. This will prompt you to log into your Synology account. Then you can sign up for a 30-day free trial. Next, you'll be prompted with the available plans for backup, starting at 100 gigabytes for only $10 per year, up to a custom number of terabytes with a scalable price. Choose your plan, hit Next, and enter your payment information. This is a trial that requires payment information, but you can cancel at any time prior to the auto renewal, so just make sure you put in a calendar reminder if you decide to not use the service. Once you finish signing up, you'll be brought back to the Disk Station Manager operating system to name the directory that your new backup task will upload to on the cloud, name it if desired, and hit Next. Choose your desired directories to backup to the C2 cloud service from your NAS, hit Next when ready. If there's any application-based data on the NAS that you wish to backup, select this as well and hit Next. Now, you have some options for the backup task. Name of the task, notifications of its status, a bandwidth cap to keep it from bottlenecking your network, and a schedule for backing up and verifying the integrity of the data, as well as client-side encryption. Choose your settings and hit Apply. The client-side encryption option is probably a good choice for the more security-minded of you out there, especially if you're uploading sensitive data to a cloud service. This will allow you to set up your own encryption key and keep all of your data completely encrypted so that neither Synology nor anyone who broke into Synology's service, if that was, you know, something that would happen, could see your data. Only you with your key. That being said, your data can't really be recovered if you lose that encryption key, but if you're already, you know, really focused on that, you're probably going to keep up with it anyway. And this works with all of the Hyper Backup options, all of the different cloud storage options available in Hyper Backup. This is specific, or you know, this isn't specific to C2 Backup. This is available for all of the Hyper Backup options. Once complete, it will ask if you wish to backup now. If you choose no, it will wait until the scheduled time slot. I said yes. Now it will upload your data. Once the data upload is complete, you have some options available to you. You can trigger another round of backups now if needed, you know, just immediately instead of waiting, or you can view the Backup Explorer, which gives you a tree of your backupped files, as well as a timeline to see different versions at the different points in time that they were backed up. You can also view some backup statistics, such as when files were added, modified, or deleted, or the size of your source backup folders, things like that. You can also go in and edit your backup task schedule or folders, view a history of backup actions, or add a new backup task altogether. The Backup Explorer can also be accessed from the Synology web portal for your NAS or from the Hyper Backup Explorer desktop program for Windows, Mac, and Linux, so that's handy. This is an important overall feature of the service, as if you don't actually need the NAS in order to restore your data. Also, their data deduplication and compression tools help save on costs, and it's all through one vendor contact for your NAS and service, which is nice. Synology C2 is a great backup tool that allows you to take full advantage of
the 3-2-1 backup strategy, which means having three copies of your important data. Two are local, so on the actual operating computer that you're running with, and then backed up to your NAS, and then one that is off-site, such as on a cloud service or a co-op internet setup, but you know, with this on Synology C2 servers. That way it's all running through the same setup. This makes it super easy, super straightforward, and integrates with, theoretically, your existing backup service. So that's pretty cool.
If you want to check it out for yourself, just install Hyper Backup on your Synology NAS or check out the link in the video description. Down there, you'll find the like button as well as a button to subscribe for more educational tech content. I'm Eeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun. I'll see you in the next one.